And so we are entering the new moon of Cancer after 3 weeks that were quite painful with Mercury in retrograde in its own month, in the month of Gemini. We are finally, you know, the light in the end of the tunnel. We are starting a brand new month today, and there are many, many opportunities that we have this month to grow. The first surprise that we have when we look at the chart of this month, of the moment that the moon is born in the month of Cancer, the moon of Cancer, we find that all the chart has got a lot of air. It still has a lot of air. It still has a spunk to it, some positive moving energy. Why is it so special? Because normally the month of Cancer, being the water of the water, it's a water sign, and it's the internal part of the sign of Cancer is also water. It's considered in the Kabbalah to be the right column of the right column. So it's this so much water that it's a bit like a tsunami. Every time that we enter the month of Cancer is that we have this huge wave coming at us of emotions, of all kind of undefined feelings. And the great gift of this year is that, yes, there is water. The moon is already in the Cancer. We still have strong water, but the air is dominant. Therefore, it's going to be much easier for us to communicate with each other during the months, to be more open to each other. Traditionally, we know that the sign of Cancer is renowned for knowing the past very well, for having unbelievable memories about their childhood, because the water is the memory of the zodiac. So when we look at the list of all the people that were Cancerians and left light in the world, we find the inventor of the printing machine, Johannes Gutenberg. We find Nelson Mandela, which was so patriotic. We find Jean-Paul Sartre, we find Henry VIII, that was very fond of beautiful instruments. We find Rembrandt, we find people that have an instinct towards the past and past values and are so very capable in everything that they do to send the vibe of the moon. We know that the moon is the only satellite of Earth and is responsible of all the waters, you know, on our planet. And this month is a fantastic opportunity not only to communicate what we feel internally and be more connected to our feelings, it's also a wonderful opportunity to heighten our intuition, our level of instinct with the people, to understand and get closer to the people around us. And that is given to us, of course, by all the air that we have at the birth of the new moon. So I want you guys to have a fantastic month. We'll talk again from the 4th of July to the 26th of July. We're going to have the 3 weeks that are going to be a little bit more difficult, but we'll have more opportunity to talk about it. So everybody have a fantastic Rosh Chodesh, a Chodesh Tov to everyone, and we'll talk soon.